in the Halmstad Arena, the combined Korean team here in semi-final action in the Women's Championship Division, up against one of the favourites, Japan, the Korean Republic team in the DPR Korea team, uniting here for this semi-final. Massive match here in these Lee Pair 2018 World Team Table Tennis Championships. All-important first match of a possible five here. Diamond Korea alongside former European champion Jill Parker taking you through the action here in Halmstad, the west coast of Sweden. It's been a terrific week, thrilling table tennis, and we're now getting towards the business end, the climax of the women's and men's championship divisions. The very best in the business now going head to head.
I mean, it's interesting because these two players have played many, many times on the ITTF World Circuit. But they haven't played each other, which I found incredible, really.
Yeah, Ito, of course, alongside Miu Hirano, a pair of teenagers, still, even with her young age, and with you, Jill, it's a little bit surprising, isn't it? We haven't met once before, but what a time to have a first meeting here in a semi-final of the World Team Championship. In the first few points here, extremely watchable already.
Ito playing with short pimple rubber on her backhand. Obviously gets different pace playing with reverse rubber and pimples. The pimples come through quite flat, but she's able to lift it and spin it as well.
Oh, beautifully done. She's right there and waiting, Ito.
Oh, that was a great angle down the line. You can see it here on the slow-mo. Just blocked it on the white line. John Gahid, right tactics, good serve, following, but perhaps not quite hard enough, and Ito was able to punch that ball.
Excellent start this from Ito, looking to impose herself from the off. The Japanese team on their feet again here. So early on to that again. It's a point you've been making, I think, chilling commentary through the week. The very best players, how early they take this ball. I mean, look to the Chinese, but the Japanese as well, so good at doing that.
Yeah, straight off the bounce, and obviously it gives your opponent less time. Got to react quickly. But even receiver serve there, very wristy action. And the opportunity, and it goes slightly long, then Ito is going to step in.
2 points from the opening game here, Ito.
Playing those points well, playing an awful lot of balls on the parallel.
8 game points then for the Japanese teenager to take this opening game. And a stroke of good fortune to close it out, but there wasn't much good fortune needed there for Mima Ito in that first game. Otherwise, excellent start. Takes the first game here, 11-2. From the higher ranked player.
And she came out of the stalls straight away, Ito, going for shots. Quite an aggressive, fast player. John Jihee in this game has got to make sure she gets in. I'm trying to dominate a little bit more. It's a good good start there for John Juhi.
Well, of course, she's come in unbeaten overall. Respective progress through to the that quarterfinal match. It's not like she's been playing badly. I just think you've got to give Ito the credit for that first game. It's very, very quick out of the blocks. This is now maybe the start of the fight back from the Korean. First 4 points going away here. Excellent, what a block there. To surprise Ito.
Ito getting off the blocks now, so John to serve. Let's see if she can keep her serves tight. Or touch play there, and then she changed it with a long, fast push.
Oh, yes.
And that was a great angle there with that backhand.
Yeah, she was performing in the opening game. Look at that, just opens up the table beautifully.
Yeah, nice one into the middle of the table. And then Jeon was sort of caught midway, and then a great angle out to the side.
And that's just as good.
That was lovely play there. Step round with the backhand on the forehand side. Banana flick. And then ended up with that lovely forehand down the line.
Well, it was the early push that was made by Jeon here. But Ito has come back to parity, second game now. His first 4 points. It's then 5 of 6 for Ito.
So John Juhi has had 8 wins. Ito 6 wins so far. Both undefeated in the tournament.
Yeah, something's got to give here. So good again at opening up, finding the angles on the table. Shorter angle there, kind of landing halfway up the table from Ito.
Yeah, committed herself to play a forehand from the backhand side and just leaned in. Got that great angle again. She plays the angle so well, Ito. She creates the opening.
Descending for a moment over the Halmstad Arena here. Doesn't mean a lot of that so far. Noise begins again, particularly from the Japanese support. Just behind their bench, they're in full voice already, cheering that success for Ito.
Saw that shovel serve again.
Yeah.
Puts that in every now and again. A lot of backspin on the ball.
It's the variety, isn't it? Because as you say, puts it in every now and again. It's the disguise that dupes Jeon there as much as anything.
Oh, and then she did that same service, but there was no spin. It popped up. John Dehee thought he had backspin on it, you can see. Pops up high. She makes that winner. Two good services by Ito to win the point. Oh, she steps around with that backhand again on the forehand side. Banana flick, very effective.
Yeah, coming around the outside of the ball, of course, imparting that side spin. Is it a banana flick or a little bit of a strawberry there, as we call it? I'm not quite sure, but it was very effective. First of these three game points saved by Gion. Still another couple here to try and fend off. We're falling two down. Emphatic comeback in that game from Mina Ito. She trailed by four at one stage, but she takes the game 11-8, and she's firmly in control now this first match. Two games up. Ito fell victim to the fight back, and it's now the Japanese woman in firm control of this first match. Two games up here in Halmstad. Kind of showed another side to her game, didn't she there, Jill? How Mina Ito's become more and more of a team player in a way. She's been very, very good individually, but how she's become very important to this team and ability to come back from behind in games as well. She's often been a very good front runner. But she had to show another side of her game, developing game there in that second.
Yes, exactly. I mean, the Japanese players fight for every ball. I mean, she was down yesterday against Ukraine, Bezoska, but she fought back and came back. So, I mean, you can never, you know, if she's behind, you can never think, oh no, she's lost this game, because she does come back.
And saved two match points in that one to beat Pisotska in that first rubber at the quarterfinal.
Very quick movement around the table. You can see how she's running with the backhand and the forehand side, then she moves back. Very quick footwork. Slow spinny one there, yes, with the short pimples.
Yeah, seem to surprise Gion. Get over the top of it enough.
Every opportunity she gets, she gets in with that strong forehand. That's a little push there, and then in.
It can work so well, really, with limited preparation time. The two coaches on the bench. I don't know what they're getting to grips with. I mean, it works both ways, doesn't it, really? Because you've got a greater pool of players who are in good form to call upon. But actually, it's not all easy, straightforward. There are some things that have got to be ironed out, because you've got two teams who've prepared for these World Championships individually.
Yeah, exactly. And then, you know, you've got the two coaches there, one from each side. Obviously, they will have discussed the situation about the matches, and probably the career DPR coach will talk primarily to his players. Likewise, Republic of Korea will talk to his players, but they're still both contributing to advice to them. And, you know, what one coach will see, another may not. So, but it's interesting that the Japanese as well have got two coaches there,
yes,
which, you know, seems fair. Normally ITTF you only allowed one, but if you've got a combined team, you'd have the two there. So obviously Japan have had that same option.
Yeah, and they've got a very, very big support network. All the biggest nations do that anyway. You've got the one nominated coach, but there's so many support staff as well with the best teams that really leave nothing, no stone left unturned. It's just a super shot. She's played that a few times where she's pivoted, gone right into a backhand corner and fired it away. So Super shot.
Yeah, she committed herself there and she really flung herself into that shot.
Just total commitment. Needs to flick that away. Can't quite get that going there. And so, Jeon takes the point. Towel down for the Korean player.
And just Ito didn't bother going. She obviously wants to keep going in the match.
Oh. Just a little bit too much ground to cover there for Jeon. And it's so short in the table.
Oh, and you can see how it kicked off the table. Got a lot of side spin on that. Forehand, step right in there. Very risky action.
Decisive for once there, watching there on the replay, Ito. A bit late in setting up for that particular forehand, might have proved the difference. So we have another timeout called. Resuming here, Jeon, with very little wriggle room at this stage. Herself level in this third game, of course, it's the best of five games. So Ito just a few points away at this stage from registering the victory.
Ito's two serves now. Let's see what she does. Oh, she started off that well. Good serve. She played a little bit faster. And then displaying backhands and forehands. And that nice forehand down the line. She skies it so well, just cocks the wrist at the last minute.
Yeah, so tough to read. A couple of very strong service points, as you suggested, Jill, that she would produce. She's one of the very best out there, and that rock-solid nature of Mina Ito's play. Bringing up two match points. Jeon looks to compose herself as she steers down the abyss here in this one. A wonderful performance, yet another one this week in Halmstad from Mima Ito of Japan to give her nation the advantage in this Women's Championship Division semi-final. Jeon Jae Hee gave everything. The combined Korean team, well, it's quite a story involved here, but it's the favourites Japan off and running with Ito's success, winning this first match in straight games.